Howdy! My name is Haley, and I'm an engineering student at the University of Colorado Boulder, studying creative technology and design. Today, I want to discuss six mighty machines that make life a lot easier for us engineers. Could you carry an elephant with just your bare hands? What if you had a group of friends to help you out? No matter how strong we are, completing tough physical tasks is near impossible without the power of machines. Thousands of years ago, humans invented simple machines to carry out massive physical challenges and transform our society into what it is today. Did you know that even without modern equipment like jackhammers, cranes, trucks, and bulldozers, simple machines are what helped the Egyptians build the Great Pyramids thousands of years ago? So, what are simple machines anyways? To put it simply, they are rudimentary devices with little to no moving parts. Simple machines are everywhere. You use them every day to perform trivial tasks. While simple machines take on many shapes and sizes, they come in just six basic categories: wedge, wheel and axle, lever, inclined plane, screw, and pulley. Without further ado, let's dive into the world of simple machines. A wedge is a simple machine that moves objects apart by applying force to a large surface area. A super common example of a wedge is a nail. A nail has a wide head area where force is applied, and a small point area where the concentrated force is exerted. This mechanism is so powerful that it can break apart super strong materials, such as wood. Some other common examples of a wedge are an axe, doorstop, zipper, and knife. A wheel and axle is a simple machine that's designed to move an object by reducing its friction. Well, what does that mean? When we try to push a heavy object, the force of friction must first be overcome to get it moving. The wheel and axle cleverly negates most of the force by friction and allows us to transport huge things with little to no effort at all. A variety of everyday examples of a wheel and axle are a car, office chair, doorknob, and roller skates. Whee! A lever is a simple machine that consists of a load, a pivot point, and a force. By exerting a force on one end of the lever, an equal force on the opposite end is applied. Some examples of a lever are a crowbar, hammer, seesaw, fishing pole, and a bottle opener. Inclined planes are simple machines that help us lift and lower things. There are two main ways to raise an object: lifting it straight up or pushing it diagonally upward. Lifting an object straight up moves it over the shortest distance, but you must exert a greater force to do so. On the other hand, lifting an object using an inclined plane requires a smaller force, but you must exert that force over a longer distance. Everyday examples of inclined planes include highway access ramps, stairs, funnels, and slides. A screw is a simple machine that consists of an inclined plane wrapped around a base. Screws may perform one of two functions: to hold things together or to lift something. Screws are especially good for holding things together because of the threading around its base. Everyday examples of screws include a jar lid, faucet, spinning stool, and light bulb. A pulley is a simple machine that's used to change the direction of a force for a variety of purposes. Even more valuable, a system of several pulleys can be used together to greatly reduce the force needed to lift an object. Some common pulleys are flagpoles, elevators, sails, and window blinds. Two or more simple machines are often combined to form a compound machine. Compound machines can accomplish massive tasks. You see compound machines all the time in your daily life, way more than you might think you do. In fact, here are just a few of the many compound machines we often encounter and use. A shovel combines a wedge and a lever. A car jack combines a lever and a screw. A wheelbarrow combines a wheel, axle, and lever. And finally, a bicycle combines a wheel, axle, and pulley. Simple machines expand engineers' toolboxes, helping them to more easily solve everyday challenges and improve our lives. Despite the power of simple machines, they won't accomplish much without thorough planning and design. In fact, planning, designing, and working as a team to overcome tough challenges is what engineering is all about. Now that you know all about simple machines, practice spotting them in the real world. How many simple machines can you find throughout your room? How about your house? Can you build your own compound machine to overcome a challenge in your day-to-day life? That's all for today. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you next time. Check out the full lesson on the Teach Engineering website. Then, apply what you learned about simple machines and the associated activities, stack it up, and choosing a pyramid site.